well, our next guest spent 10 years living the high life as a Virgin Atlantic flight attendant. But now Mandy Smith is spilling the beans on just what goes on up in the sky in her new book, Cabin Fever. Now, every morning show in Australia wants to talk to her, but Mandy Smith is speaking exclusively to us here at Studio 10. And she joined us live from London. Mandy, good morning to you.
Good morning. How are you?
We are terrific. Right, thanks, now, talk Mandy. Me through it, because being an airline hostess once upon a time was a job of great prestige and glamour. What's it like now?
Yes, I believe people used to have to be a nurse to start off originally, but now it's changed slightly, I think.
Or at least just wear the uniform.
Because, Mandy, what a book. I mean, it is very saucy. There's some really quite sort of revealing, juicy bits in it. What is the most sort of, I suppose, exciting experience that you went through?
I think the glamorous parties is probably going to stand out for me. I've travelled the world and did lots of things with famous people, and it was a really nice experience.
Courtney Love, Sir Richard Branson himself, what went down there?
There's one party I can remember specifically with Richard. We were in Toronto, and it was an inaugural for... We'd just started flying there, so basically... Richard got up on stage and started dancing as the backing dancers to the Weather Girls and started stripping off, bless him. Oh.
Doesn't take much for Richard Branson to do that.
Loves a bit of publicity.
I think it was planned.
Yeah. Now, Mandy, can you either dispel or confirm the myth that the Mile High Club back when you were working was rampant? You know, everyone was doing it in the bathrooms.
I guess it's on everyone's bucket list, or a few people's bucket list. But there's always going to be the odd people that will try it on a commercial airliner. And
have you?
We usually catch them.
Oh, my.
Have I? Not while I was at work, but I did in a two-seater aircraft with my boyfriend.
Oh. Two-seater aircraft.
Well, he was flying.
I was going to say, who was the pilot? I was a bit concerned about...
Well, he was flying.
Who was the pilot?
Yes.
Oh, that's all right, then, because I was going to say
logistics.
Two of you in the pilot.
I'll leave the logistics to your imagination.
Mandy, we always hear about celebrities and other people behaving badly on planes. How about the people who are actually a delight to fly with? Did you have some people who you thought, I'd love to have them back on my plane again because they were so easy to look after?
Yes, I must admit, there's lots of... we probably miss about 1,000 people a week. And there's only a handful that were a nightmare. So the majority of passengers are lovely. But we had a lot of unique passengers who fly more regularly than the cabin crew.
Give us some names, some celebrities, come on. People who are nice.
Celebrities, lovely. Oh, gosh, honestly. Grace Jones, she was really nice. I know some people think she's quite challenging, but I loved Grace. And I actually quite got on with Courtney Love.
Oh, interesting.
And Robbie Williams. Oh. Yeah, they're really sweet. I only flew with them, only served them a couple of times. But.
And what about the most annoying passengers? What is the worst or the most ridiculous kind of requests or behaviour you've seen when you've been working on a plane?
I think the most annoying thing when you're an air stewardess is when you're talking to somebody and they'll let you finish a sentence and then they go... Sorry, what was that? You have to repeat everything twice for 400 people. Yeah.
Because more than that, you've also been you've been groped by passengers on planes. You've had food thrown at you. I mean, it's not the glamour that it was sort of in, you know, days gone by.
Yeah, that's I'm afraid to say that's all par for the course. Unfortunately, you are trained to deal with people in customer service, and I think in most customer service jobs you come across that kind of thing. It's just when you're stuck in the air with people, it's a bit more serious, I think.
Yeah, well, just groping seems weird. I don't know many other jobs that people just get groped randomly.
Television news, I would say. one take home message from your 10 years as an air hostess, what would it be, Mandy?
Oh, just go out in there and live life. It's, you know, everything's out there to be had, really, and just travel the world. Great place.
Fantastic. Excellent, excellent, and know where your exits are. Mandy, thank you very much for joining us. Mandy's book, Cabin Fever, The Sizzling Secrets of an Air Hostess, is available now at all good bookstores.